The play clock's running down. And with the play clock almost up, Hugh Jackson's going to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll run it now out of the gun. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Mariota now from the 50, completing it to the right side, Johnson. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Second down, Mariota. The 20. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and 1.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
Ordinarily, in short yardage, most people don't run a toss because it takes a little bit longer to develop. Some teams see it as a very physical type run because the amount of people that get out in front of the runner, offensive linemen, tight end, sometimes an extra back, they like to run that play there and try and run over people.
And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches used to say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone.
And he takes this one in for a Brown score. A great play there, taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Browns have taken the early lead. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
This will be taken in at the 1. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. I think even more so, you just want to avoid 3 and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as well.
As you and I know from visiting a lot of camps, no one practices this type of a start, do they?
Not, especially not on the road. You give up the touchdown on the opening drive, now there's likely a 3 and out on your first possession.
Yeah, you throw that incompletion there, you hate to fall into a hole early, especially on the road. Got to be careful.
The 3 straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on 4. They'll try and throw for it here. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well short of a first down. And partner, I'm not really sure what in the world they were thinking on fourth and long there at this stage in the game, but you think social media may be firing up a little bit right now?
Oh, the coach is trending right now. All right, there's no doubt about it. People wonder what that decision was. But it takes me back to a number of years ago, a very successful coach in the league.
And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. A great effort there with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Browns add on to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. Then he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Just keeping the play. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And complete on the right side. It's Tammy. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Back to throw here. Going underneath to Blunt. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Terrell Suggs. From his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Tammy's got it, complete. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. Still in search of the first down after that last completion. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete. Certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. So 4th and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. He'll look to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And that will force a turnover on downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
So when you call a corner blitz, what a lot of teams call a cat blitz, you expect him to come after the quarterback. But in this case, he ran into the ball carrier. Really nice technique, because what you do is you come deep as the deepest offensive player so he can't get outside of you.
On third down, it's Jackson. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. Pass the 20, 10, 5, and all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A big play there.
Always hating, said I'll never make it. I already exhaust talking with them. It's okay. I already mad at me cause I'm getting money. I already mad at me goodies on me. It's okay. Cause I'm shining. They ain't seen it when I'm young, out here grinding. It's okay, yeah. Either way, young, getting paid, yeah. I already mad at me cause I'm popping. They don't want to put some money in my pockets. It's okay, yeah. Either way, a hater always gonna hate, yeah. Mad at me cause I'm trying to feed my. I'm supposed to make it out and I don't bring my. No way, yeah. They ones and they here to stay, yeah. I already always hating, said I'll never make it. I already always talking with them. It's okay, yeah. I already mad at me cause I'm getting money. I already mad at me, goodies on me. It's okay.
I heard he tryna lie me, but I ain't no dummy. It's okay though, got it, you really want it. I spent 13 on the ring and now I feel unlucky. And she love my diamond ring, she said she wanna touch it.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Suckup, the man tasked with getting this one started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. This one fielded at the 5. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Jackson. And some room to work. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield, get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. And some extras coming up on the line here. Redding for the blitz. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of 4. Now third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
The first carry now for Adrian Peterson.
And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
If you're the coaching staff upstairs, you might want to file that play away. Did you see how fast the safety closed on that one? Coming up in run support, made a big-time tackle. Might want to try and check into a pass next time.
Yeah, got him for a loss. Really, really great play defensively. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches. Running for it, here's Peterson. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll run it now out of the gun. There he goes, left side. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. A great play there. 28 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
Throughout the game, we're going to track so many different statistics, but one is becoming increasingly in vogue. Explosive runs of 20 yards or more, and we just saw one right there to open this game.
Now we'll see how the other team responds, because when you get a play like that against you this early in the game, got to feel like your back's against the wall a little bit.
Yeah, the pressure now increases on you because your first thought is we have to answer right now.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Now a first down throw for Newton. Escaping the pressure right. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
So second and 10 here. Play action, it's Newton. Flushed out right. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Used to have a coach just tell us all the time, those scouting reports aren't just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
Now it's Newton, here off the bootleg. Steps away to his left. And now another one thrown incomplete.
Now that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. And Cam Newton's not coming off the field. He'll keep the offense out to go for it on fourth. They will go for it. Now Newton. Looking deep downfield. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by Terrell Suggs. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25.
That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And that's going to bring up a third down. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him two touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on fourth down, that's big for the defense.
So after the pick, they can't capitalize for six, but they do get three.
And I know in this situation, most of us wanted to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that's going to be knocked away and incomplete. And with it, time has expired on the first quarter. Second down following the incompletion. Now a play fake, and it's Newton. Flush to his right. And he finds a man with a crossing route. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Newton to throw, escaping the pressure right. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A really nice gain of 25 yards. On first and 10, Newton. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Here's Newton. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Back to throw, Newton. Now he'll escape to his right. Room here to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football. Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
On second and 10, Newton flushed out right. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Terrell Suggs. And to the 12, that's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. So don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
And he'll be taken down at the 18. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. The 30, 20, 10, and touchdown. A great effort there. 82 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again and again,
again
and again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
This will be fielded at the 8. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. They go play action here on 1st down, eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep. And look at this, Cam Newton intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off down near the 5. And now nothing but green ahead of him. And oh, at the end of it, he's stripped. Ball comes loose. Oh, and this is going to wind up a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on, come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points. Now this offense about ready to take over again. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? 2 touchdowns on a field goal in their first 3 possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
So while the offense has had a big day, no one on that side of the ball is excited about seeing a loss like that. Their goal, to make every play positive. And when you have a bad one like that, your next goal is to not let it spiral into more.
Now here's a timeout defensively. Defensive timeout called by the Jets. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Now the Jets are going to burn another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. It's a pickup of 19. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Now they'll run it on the toss. A swift move, but not a ton to show for it. Tackle just on the other side of midfield. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Now a 2nd down throw for Mariota. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. On 1st and 10, here's Mariota. This will be caught inside the 10. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. No move for the field goal unit. They're going to go here with 5 seconds left. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. And it's caught. Touchdown. Travis Kelce in the final seconds of the first half. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical.
Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Sit like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show 'em how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show 'em how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's hands in his hands, feeling like a man. Run, put him, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live without it. Red light, stop, green light, go. Everything ain't what it seem like. Been in, this is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? A box under the bridge, like Anthony Kiedis, looking for something to complete us and maybe lead us. A long way from equalists, how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television to see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some. Everybody love, everybody know. I've been knocking dough down like it. Witness, God is my witness, I'm witness. But on the real, I think I need another witness. If it was 17, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin, certified as a house. Go figure, in my blood is the blood, venom master. It's like the devil playing spades with the pastor. But he was born with the privilege. Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Cleveland. That'll be taken in the end zone. And not a good return here. He is brought down at the 7-yard line.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's up past the 10 to about the 12. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
From this vantage point, that seems like a pretty dangerous call, running a toss that close to your own goal line. I think what they were hoping is that they were going to get some pressure from the defensive front and maybe beat them to the corner and then turn upfield with a lot of yardage to run.
It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a 3rd and 3.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
Flush to his right. Complete. It's Johnson. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's 4th down. A little risky there when you roll out of that pocket right like he did. You complete the pass, but you don't get anything out of it.
But how many times have we seen when a quarterback exits out of the pocket, doesn't matter if they go left or right, the defense loses its leverage, right? There's a little chaos back there, and receivers come open. Great discipline on that play. They didn't let that happen, and held it to no gain.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. A good run there on 1st down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2. Ah! They'll run it now out of the gun. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It's a loss of two, now third down.
That definitely sets up a much more difficult third down.
Yeah, you figure second and two, one they thought they could pick up. Now you're facing third and four.
Yeah, got to give the front seven a lot of credit for making that play. I'm just starting to wonder, partner, is second and short also a throwing down in the NFL now?
Throwing, Mariota. This is Johnson. He's got it. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Now the first carry for Adrian Peterson. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it second and 12. Again, Peterson. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. They'll try to capitalize on play number 11 of this opening drive. Third and goal. To throw is Mariota. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Now a play fake here on first down. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Here's Foles. That is incomplete. Six-time Pro Bowler Calvin Johnson, the intended target. And it's third down.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch, but underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
Foles. Man open, Rice. 15 yards through the air and a first down. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out. They're able to avoid that there.
Yeah, we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to them. Hey, you guys got the turnover? We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
And it's knocked away and incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver, and now it's second down.
We talk all the time about playmakers on offense, but let's face it, there are plenty of playmakers on defense, too. I think we just saw an example of one, didn't we? Not force that incompletion.
Yeah, he's a great corner. They got a couple of them on that side of the football. Play action fake. They'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time. And that takes us from second to third down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Now Foles. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, helped force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. They're going to try and throw. Try to lay one up deep. And this is going to be incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland.
And that's exactly what you're supposed to do with good field position. You make the other side pay when you don't have far to go for the score.
Lions suck up on for the point after. It's up and through to make it 7-0 Browns. Now here's Suckup out to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. Running right through it. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks. Right near the 27. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
With Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's our visiting. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. Going up top. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, 3rd down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he won't get much. Maybe a couple. Down inside the 35 and the 34.
And that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation. Showing a shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a 3rd down situation.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
They'll set up to throw. That's complete. It's Bell. 8 yards there and a 1st down. Bell is so good at that. He just catches so many passes near the line of scrimmage. In fact, the unique stat line for him last year, he had more yards after the catch than total receiving yards from the line of scrimmage on the season.
That doesn't even sound real, but when you analyze his game, you understand why a stat like that can occur. His ability to catch the ball, be elusive, and also strong enough to break tackles, that allows him to gain all that extra yardage. I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And it's caught. Touchdown. Jerry Rice, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. That's one of those touchdown tosses where if it's an inch to the right or left, it's not a touchdown. He had to put it right on the money.
Yeah, and how did he do that? Everything around him, everything swirling, all the coverage downfield. Somehow he spotted the opening and put it right there.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, that's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to run with.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Basically, you're not going to outwork two guys very often.
Double coverage. I thought he was going to go somewhere else with the football. I get it. That's a stud wide receiver. You want to try to get him the football.
Yeah, sometimes you rely on him a bit too much. You forget.
Tries to force it to Megatron, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And some space here. And all the way in for the touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, 40 yards. And his guys have taken the lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now the Browns coming out on the field. Yardage here, back to the 15. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. The Browns on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 15. They go play action. Mariota. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And they will finally get him down as he's all the way to the 36-yard line.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
Being chased out left, and he is out of bounds inside the 30. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. He was out there waving his arms. When you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Jerry Rice, as the first half is winding down. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. The intended receiver there, Allen, that'll bring up second down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes his quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Now Mariota. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Time for a break. We've hit half. And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency.
This is intercepted. Picked off by Levante David, and they will take over at the 29-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off around the 41.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation. But sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to air one out. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 5. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. His defense figured out something in the locker room. That's 2 third-quarter picks now.
And you just wonder, did he get too comfortable in the locker room himself? His team has the lead. Take care of the football. He's putting them in jeopardy right now.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll go down for a loss inside his own 5 at the 4. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11. And he'll give it here to his running back. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
On 3rd down, Mariota. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 23. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
The play fake. He'll look to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind. Because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmaker. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Cameron Hayward in there to get him for a loss of five. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. From the gun, Mariota. Flushed out right. And his throw is incomplete. Johnson the intended target, and it's third down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
Now Mariota. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off.
I come here today to talk about how I feel. And I feel like that we are treated differently than other people. And I don't like how we're treated in it. Just because of us doesn't mean anything to me.
It's just the way I feel. Mine's been racing so long, yeah. It's just no way to deal with these problems alone. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. Selfish people, I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, now everybody got problems, yeah, but we didn't know one way to solve them. I really came up from the bottom, struggling my mama on the last dollar. Hustling and I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental prisons. When I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the listen. I've been on a mission.
Charles and I set for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. The big left foot of Sebastian Janikowski ready to get us started. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six. Now they'll run it on the toss. And some room to maneuver. He's at the 30, the 20, 10, 5, and all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A big play there. 68 yards. And the Browns have taken the early lead. You talk about explosion plays. Here's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown. They're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Now here's Suckabout to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And the back goes into motion. On play action, now Rodgers. Buying time to his left. And he's got Rome. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
They'll run with Davis, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford, used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, he'd always say, foul it away, lad, foul it away, because he'd want to come back to it later in a key situation. They may come back to this one a little more often than that.
Didn't he say laddie or did he say lad?
Yeah, it just depends on what he was feeling at the moment.
Okay, I thought that was the guy you told me about that used to say laddie a lot.
Laddie?
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Levante David.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
Khalil Mack's starting to get a really big-time reputation as a pass rusher, and rightly so. So explosive off the edge, getting to the quarterback. But he doesn't neglect his run duties as well. How about that tackle right there? Such a package he has, able to play the run and the pass so well.
Third and long here for Mariota. And in incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. So possession one ended in six. Possession two likely going to end in a punt.
And that's okay. They just got to get back to what they worked on in the opening drive and continue to make a few.
And they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. It's such a risky play there to fake it. You're either the hero or the GOAT. Here they're going to be the GOAT.
Unfortunate, too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just to call it. They don't just say, oh.
Davis fighting. He loses the football. And this is picked up by the Browns. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And they put it on the ground here on the second drive. And, of course, Charles, that follows drive number one where they had the INT.
Makes you wonder what's going on with this team, because a lot of times we can attribute it to nerves, but maybe it's a lack of focus. Maybe it's the preparation for the game. Maybe they just came into a little lackadaisical, because that's just not looking good at all. That's just not the football that we came here to see.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And to give this time to the tailback. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
On third down, that's Jackson. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
So certainly an interesting call there to go for it, and the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. Play action here on first down. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 13. He's at the 50. 30. Past the 20. 10. 5. And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. And his defense looking like they have come to play the pick six. And just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visit. What do we hear during these drills? Oh, pass.
Pass.
Ball. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite. Now here's Suckabout to kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position.
They'll start at the 32 yard. The road to the playoff, man. I'm definitely trying to make it to the playoffs right now. And all mad, and I'm 3-2, I believe, right now. One of them, they gave me an air out, so they won't really count me. Most of my time today, they had 99 shots on one for 97 Billy Rice. They had a nice team. Right now, definitely being a little on the defensive side.
I'll
go another one. If y'all watch this, man, the defense is lit, man. I don't know why he keep doing all these short passes. Knowing I'm about to come and lay him out.
Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
They find some open field here, and he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And down in inside the 15 he goes. A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 and a first down.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Eluding the pressure right. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Run him out.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open.
Already.
Once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That'll go as a loss of 5. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now. Play action now. Mariota. Flush to his right. He may try and run for this. And I think the ball's out. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. 1:59 to go in the first half. More from Cleveland after this. First and goal here from the 2. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll try to throw now. Mariota. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Now a handoff here to his running back. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And it'll be 2nd and goal. Toss. And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. A great play there with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Browns add 6 to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, have your fun. All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Rodgers now on 1st down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Geno Atkins, never giving up. He's able to keep working and get him for a loss of 12. Throwing on 2nd down. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. They give him a gain of 38. Now they got to get to the line quickly.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning.
Second down, here's Rodgers. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Now it's Rodgers, and this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence, haven't allowed a point yet, flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Now Rodgers, and he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Get this one across the 35. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Final play of the half here, Mariota. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. And they'll get him to the ground, but he got all the way down to the 30-yard line. Hang on, we'll jump over halftime. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. 6 yards on the pickup, and just like that, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain of 19 in picking up the first. And he goes in motion here in the backfield. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Read it well and it's picked. And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35.
This has been one mistake after another on the offensive side of the ball. That's now 3 interceptions to go along with 2 fumbles for him. And if you're going to turn the ball over 5 times in a game, your chances to win have to be about 100-1. And it's not looking good for him here.
Shift together here from the D-line. They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, and sometimes that just happens. It is the NFL. They will make some plays against you.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. escaping the pressure right. Going deep here for Allen. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field. And really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. The Browns on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 14. Throwing, Mariota. Right back for Allen. This time he finds him complete. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. They're indeed going. It's Mariota. Oh, fighting off the defender. Flushed out right. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. That'll move the sticks for the Browns. A gain of 12.
Man.
And he was so upset about that right there, he just closed his app. Give me some tune-ups out here. No oil tanks. Definitely hit that like button. Definitely sub if you're new to viewing my channel and my streams. Man, I be getting lit every morning on this matter, man. And I definitely win a lot of games. Let's check in. You definitely want to challenge me. If you got PS4, you definitely can leave a comment. And I definitely will give you my PSN. So we can link up and get it in, man. Everybody got fights, yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till they leave their life. Another mama crime, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live right years. Are you willing to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never saw my soul because that's... Ballin', what's up, young Cole, man? How you got your day going, homie? You see me out here ballin', man.
For this Madden Ultimate Team matchup, these guys on your screen ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game, and speaking of the game,
yeah, I got another easy one, man.
On to get it started now, the kicker Chris Boswell, and off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. This will be fielded at the 6. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line.
He's right here. He's playing on the outline, though. So he's going to get filled by 74. 74, oh, well, he changed over now. 74 still going to fill him.
Now I'm just going
to turn it up. All right, I ran into my blocker. I'm going to try this one more time on the other side. I'm going to pass it up to this.
I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Because those defenders, they're
rallying
to the football.
He's just going to the other side now. Okay.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Right through him.
Boom, bam, biff.
And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield.
A little better. Going to the other side. Watch that track. Whew. Oh my God, that was nasty. Just checking my team out right now. Actually looking to see how my offensive line is looking. You know, my offensive line is like 94s, 93s. They still do their job, though. I did have a whole lot of 95s on there, but I changed them up. Got more better skill positions. I got Keelan Allen I just got today. So I feel one of my offensive linemen to get him downgraded his position for a 93. So the run gets he's still running over to it, so. With a fresh set of downs. My overall dropped to a 93, though, but it's still killing. He's still balling.
Now, out of the gun. And he's got some space here. 10 more there and another first down.
Well, so they're running the ball pretty well on this drive, and all I remember as a secondary guy was if you're making a lot of tackles in a game, that's usually not good for your defense. You've got to figure out how to keep things in front of you because you know there's three levels. Defensive line, linebackers, and into the secondary.
Well, I hear about to have him, y'all. I'm about to pass it this time. And I know he's about to blitz everybody.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. First down, here's a run with Peterson. And he'll take it in.
Well, Jackson, the AP is my two running backs, man. The 93 AP is a dog. One of them got his chemistry. The offensive line, perfect chemistry. He's got acceleration boost. His acceleration boost is like a 92, and his rushing boost is like a 95. But he's still a good card to use as a backup. And I realize he just definitely just took off on that play.
Now here's Suckabout to kick it away.
If I stop with my defense, he might be out of here, y'all. I'm going to see what my defense do. He might smack him right here. Ooh. He smacked him, though. He held on to it, though. I'm going to go man one time, see what he about. Put a spy on over Smith. Put my Davidson. Get my dudes off. Everybody's on the run. Definitely not running with Keith Davis, so we got a lid on that.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one. I
ain't gonna put a spy on me right now. So this quarterback don't look that accurate. That's what he's gonna run, so.
Just as they did on that last play.
Now it's Trubisky.
He went to the wrong side. He had a good opening on the other side, but he went to that way.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
On third down, Trubisky.
I knew what he was doing. Give me a ball over there.
This one just shy of midfield, all the way to the 49. They give him 27 yards on the third down.
Back to zone. I had him viewed up in man, but I messed up. I knew he was trying to go to that tight end. I thought he was going over there and doubled him, but I didn't.
They'll run it now, out of the gun.
Real Davis ain't really got to run on that defense, that's for sure. And that's not really slowing down from running his offensive pick.
Defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there.
And that's all the man picked, man. Ray Lewis, what are you doing?
Pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Brandon, lest my eyes deceive me, I think they found a matchup that they're trying to exploit here, don't you? I mean, that's the second time they've gone to him here on this drive.
Yeah, opening drive, it's a total.
He's playing Rockets in there now, y'all.
Yeah, and I think that the way things are going right now, they like him as a featured receiver. Let's see what kind of adjustments the defense is going to make to try and take that away.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down, dancing to his left, and avoids the contact by sliding. The improv on the scramble,
that
gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, right, and now he made it a very manageable second and
short. This right here, like, dude, the deal right here.
On second down, here's Trubisky.
Yeah. Oh, Davidson, pick that.
He was trying to get it to Jerick McKinnon there, and that'll make it third down.
The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
Yo, man, come on, pick that off.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth.
He blew it.
This is a complete mishit.
He blew
it's
it, dog.
Good. Didn't even get it there. And this score will stay right.
He's out of here. I knew it. Once he missed that, that hurt his feelings. Fellas, he's out of here. Just missed a 15-yard field goal, man. I know he's pissed. All right, I'm 5-2. Let's go. Two more games. I'm have to change it to the road to the championship. Shout out to my nigga Young Code, man. Thank you for tuning in, for sure. This boy out here getting lit, man.
Tuning these guys up, no oil change. That's a good motor. That's a good logo.
That's only two games. I'm gonna take a little break, run to the show, give me some snacks. Me and my baby girl, but stay tuned for the road to the championship when I come back. Definitely got to tune in to that. But if y'all look at the game I lost, man, the dude had 99 Carson Wentz, Jerry Rice, and I forget who else we had. But
and you heard a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started.
I don't really see what players he has, so we just let around.
Ryan Succop, the man tasked with getting this one started. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. This one taken from the 7. Play clock down to 5, and they're going to burn a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Definitely. I'm about to jump at the man the first play. I'm going to let him know what I really like to play first, so I can adjust to him after that, see what he's going to do. Looks like he don't want to pick a play. What's going on, man? Okay, there we go. But it's fine, just in case. Oh, yeah.
They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff. And it's complete. Over the middle to Clark. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Now Goff on first down. Caught left side, Hopkins. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall near the 48-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Here's Goff now on second down.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
But when you're going up against a talented receiver like that, you just know that they're going to bring more people to him, right? They're going to double cover him every chance they get.
I think that that is what we're going to see all game long, an early taste of that double, maybe even sometimes triple coverage we might see.
Yeah, I think what they're counting on, his talent to sometimes beat that double coverage.
It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
I think I used to what he's doing. If I get used to what he's doing, then I'm going to shut him down all the way.
Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Talking to the goal line.
Let's just go ahead and state the obvious.
You're
going to want a big game out of that guy. Big time
no
run
to
get things started.
Here.
But even more importantly, coming in on the road, trying to silence the crowd, take them out of it a little bit.
And we'll take this one in for a touchdown. Todd Gurley, a 15-yard touchdown run. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves sticking in the end zone on a running play.
Here's Prater now set to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line.
I'm not trying to run all over him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up to about the 40. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. He'll wind up losing 3, and now it's third down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you could see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
And it is incomplete. A curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And that will force a turnover on downs. Now this offense ready to head back out there. They have to be thrilled with that first drive. They got him the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a 2-score advantage here on the road.
And you know they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
They'll throw underneath for Gurley. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
On first down, it's Gurley. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
That's a really nice play. Be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They
allowed him
to run free and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a 1-yard gain.
That's for the house,
y'all.
I know
in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost, and now, there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline as he could not come up with that football.
Throwing on third. Gone. And he's able to find Diggs. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. On first and goal, Gurley. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard. that's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Another try on second down with Gurley. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three.
Has already scored once. He definitely had his eyes wide open trying to get in there a second time, but I thought that was a really nice play defensively to deny him.
Yeah, it was, as you said, keeping him away from his second first quarter touchdown there. Now Goff on third and goal, and that is incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And this has no chance. It's no good. Well, wide to the left. And this square will stay right where it is. So a bullet dodge there defensively. They surrender excellent field position on the kick return, but it winds up not costing them a thing.
And that's a tough sequence of events from an offensive perspective. The inability to get first downs leads to the field goal try. And the inability to cash that in leads to nothing on the scoreboard.
Second down. And that one is incomplete. And it also concludes quarter number one. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number two. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
Yeah, up there. What's going on, Jay? Got nothing to say.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
They'll try and throw for it here. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trumaine Johnson. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
After the interception, here's Goff. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink.
If you have to learn from King JJ, he's real, man.
They're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Gurley again here on first down. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get his 2nd touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier. Was bidding for a 2nd. And they'll turn to a power game to try to get in. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. They give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be 3rd and goal. Their fullback try and push the pile. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on 4th and goal. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And the lead moves to 10-0. So a good kick that time, and he's able to redeem himself from the previous miss.
And fortunately for him, he got the chance to do that not long after missing the first time. Sometimes a whole game goes by, and you don't get that chance at all. So you keep it with you till the next time you take the field.
And the Browns getting set to go. It's been an awfully slow start for them. This is their third possession. They don't have a first down yet.
So that means they have to change up what they're doing. And for some teams, it's a change in tempo, usually moving it to more up-tempo type of an offense just to try and change their fortunes right now. What they've been doing so far isn't working. Maybe they'll do that.
It's a pickup of three, and we have now arrived at the two-minute warning. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be knocked down sideways. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Maybe a little sign of life here offensively, Charles. They get their first down. They didn't have any in quarter number one.
And I think what we're seeing is great evidence of good scouting by both teams, right? Understanding what they like to do, their best plays, try and take those away early. So now we're seeing some adjustments, and they end up getting their first down.
They'll try to throw now. Mariota. And this is caught. First catch for Keenan Allen. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not
because
at all.
Those are the types of plays that he provides. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A five-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal. First down now, but the clock continues to move. First down, Mariota. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. On second down, Mariota again. Flush to his right. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. They'll run for it with Peterson. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
Now, this feels like old-school football because this has turned into a good old-fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on fourth down?
So a field goal here. They're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
And that is what you call a hit stick. Put down to the ground hard at the 18-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're...
The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A great effort there. 75 yards. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Time to establish the run game here. Gurley. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
The football, it's loose, and this is picked up by the Browns, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality,
and he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Keenan Allen, 38 yards, and the Browns have taken the lead. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd, and they asked about halftime adjustments and all that that was going on. And remember what I said? It's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes just remembering the game plan and playing better, tuning it up and just working through it methodically, they got it done in this case.
Of course, I'll always remember that appearance because I had on a brown belt with black shoes and you pointed that out in front of the crowd. So thanks for that.
I said that out loud.
You did.
My bad.
They go play action here on first down. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards. On first down, it's gone. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. A first down throw for Mariota. Throws left side complete to Keenan Allen. And all the way in. Touchdown.
Show up, baby. Harder, go up, go up. Boy, don't touch. We
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Soldier Field. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line.
If you're checking out my team, Big Poppy about to get torch. Let's play. He got Brian Urlacher, so he got him up to a 90. Yeah, I wonder what his speed on. I should have texted him last night getting to a 98. These defense must be all the same chemistry. Oh, he ain't quitting yet. I'm about to make him, though.
On the run, this is Jackson. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. They run again with Jackson, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. From the shotgun, it's Mariota looking for Allen. He's got him on the slam. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass or what they do. We're about to find out. Fourth down. Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A gain of four on the play, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a play fake here on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. A second down throw here for Mariota. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And it'll bring up a second and 14. Throwing is Mariota. Forced out to his left. And incomplete. Now they're coming up on play number 8 of this opening drive, but they're looking at a 3rd and long. Mariota now from the 50. He's going to fire one deep over the middle, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on 3rd down to bring up 4th. So on 4th down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And it appears they'll go for it here on 4th down. A big call on the game's opening drive. From the gun, Mariota. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
This is such a good read defensively. They know that this offense is going to try to get the ball to their playmaker in space. So what do? They crowd him and send bodies at him. And this one winds up being intercepted.
Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. Jordan Howard, and able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good
Trubisky
draw play, gives to Howard, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40.
He definitely ain't running on my defense, but he didn't do that all day.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats, but really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Now it's Trubisky. Now he'll let it go deep over the pit. It's caught inside the 25. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. A big gain of 3 feet there on 3rd down.
He just threw them. You have some pressure on him, yeah.
Let's go! Detroit!
Out of the gun, Trubisky. On the right side, this is Miller. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another 1st down. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their 1st drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off, because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out, you've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
2 big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal.
Here we go. Gun.
From the shotgun is Trubisky.
Something wrong, man. That's the end of it, bro.
Almost picked off. That's what you expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's 2nd down.
Even though nigga, now he's about to probably score because y'all are blowing turnovers.
This is Howard on 2nd down. And a little bit of space there. Takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
They'll let the fullback try and take
it.
Into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. It's the fullback taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Bears are in for six. Oh, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there, and this will stay a six-point ball game. Butker now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Shake off the interception from the last drive. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? And they'll start this drive with very good field position.
All right, here we go.
After the interception, here's Trubisky. Steps away to his left. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Detroit!
On second down, here's Trubisky. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Super Bowl 49 hero Malcolm Butler. It's a foot race, the 30. And this results in six, touchdown. Well, we know this defense has athleticism.
I love the way
I don't know why the women didn't play my nigga in the championship, dog.
Both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
Oh, I don't know, I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on, come on.
Fine. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded at the 2. Knocked down from the side, right at the 20. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Let's go. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
On second down, Trubisky. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. So the offense has it first and 10. Throwing once more, it's Trubisky. He gets it left side to Johnson. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of six there on first.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Johnson. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue. On first and 10, it's Trubisky. Collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down now after the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit right near the 39. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four. From the gun, it's Trubisky. That's complete to Meredith. And a great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps him pick up the first. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Now Trubisky on first down. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Throwing here, Trubisky. Escaping the pressure right. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Johnson was the intended receiver, and now it's third down. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying no more. We're taking a stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
15 yards down to the 15 and a first down. And that extra yardage makes this upcoming field goal attempt much more manageable.
Agreed, because when you talk to defensive coordinators, they always tell us the 35-yard line on our side of the field, that's the line we guard the most aggressively, because once they get there, they believe they're in field goal range.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So here's the Bears' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. First down, Trubisky. They still can't get it. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
That one good for 10 yards, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Try to run for it with Howard. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. They'll throw on first down with Trubisky. And incomplete on the deep ball. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
He really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Second and 10 now. It's Trubisky being chased out left. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time. And I think we were both wondering, once he got out of the box, whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Hurry up, here we go.
On third down, Trubisky. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Already was, sir.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9.
No. Check. Patriot.
They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive. On first down, they run with Howard. Even with that broken tackle, he'll be brought down short of the 15. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
They go with Howard again. Howard has the first down and then some. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
Another nice run there by Jordan Howard. And when we talk about fresh
legs, I'm about to get a tune up. No, not today, sir. I'm about to tune this nigga up. This week, ass nigga.
Heck, the number two rusher in the NFL behind another rookie, Ezekiel Elliott.
Tune this nigga up,
sir. Season, he only had 12 carries, so once week 4, he really found his groove. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. But call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. They don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get...
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. It's the fullback. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bears will add on to their lead. And when the smaller guy can't power it across the goal line, Charles, sometimes you need to go with a fullback. They did.
Almost, huh? Yep, almost had it. This nigga cheated me. That would have been a pickup fumble. Stop on the goal line. Now this nigga threw it. This is what I'm talking about, man.
Butker now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Oh, he's got a little daylight. He's got daylight. He's at the 30, 20, 10. And they will finally get him down. How about that return? They'll be
scoring buddy.
As time has run out in this third quarter. So now it's first and goal. A give to the fullback on the dive. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. It's the fullback punching it in from a yard away. And his guys have made this a one-score game now.
Hey, it didn't matter, man. I was getting in there regardless, so.
Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They'll give it to the fullback up the middle. And he will bowl his way in there for the 2 points. Now here's Suckup out to kick it away.
That way, nigga.
Taken at the three. Turn, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior. Big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get in front and keep the ball moving.
And now the defense may be looking out for a pass.
Come on, man.
Taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. Give him 30 yards there. On the give, this is their fullback. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Now, that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
8 yards to go here on second down.
Brian Earl at the 98.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. Touchdown, Chicago.
I'm fucking up.
Will extend their lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
That's for six weeks, man.
Oh, without a doubt, you need that difference maker.
I need to make a shot, bro.
Butker now to kick this one away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So the D-line's going to spread out. Mariota on first down. And this one's
going to be good. That's what I have, man. I know I'm turning this nigga up. No, dude. I'm about to come back and win this, dude. Mario won't throw no pick on me.
So this offense really needs to make something happen here late in the fourth with the football.
Alan, he all right there.
Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. He's going to launch
now, see how well he is now. Oh no, he's shitty, dog. He ain't got no speed. I told you. He ain't got no fucking speed. One on one, man. He's probably more fat nigga.
They'll begin the drive with Howard. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. Again, it's Howard. Now Howard strips.
Let's go, G.
Here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. On the ground, this is Jackson.
It's the boy Brett, man. You see how much he just popped up?
Looking to speed things up, going with some tempo.
That way. Now I got to get in this motherfucker.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. Now a second down throw for Mariota, eluding the pressure right. Now he's able to work it near the 8-yard line. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football.
And they just have to make it stand up one more time, because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted.
We still love, dude. I can't stand this many defense, man. This is a
sad. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line.
Well, they needed the touchdown and the two-point conversion, but they're not going to get a shot at either. This is a great play here defensively, Brandon, and at a time that they sorely needed one. And that could be enough to help get them out of here with a victory.
Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They go with Howard to begin the drive. And he's going to be taken down here at about the 10. And there will be a break in the action here. They're going to take a timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Trubisky with a give to Howard. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
On the handoff, this is Howard. And he's into the clear. He's at the 50. 30. The 20, 10, and he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about.
I need one more win to make the playoffs, or one more loss to get start all over, man. This is some bullshit. That's why I don't fuck with you, JJ. Every time you come in here, I lose, sir.
How dare you to stop the truth? You're good and way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the you.
Tell him again. Them boy dare try to suck the truth. Nightbox on your ass, eh? Round there like a bad boy, do it. Run all the talking, go on and do it. Running through the party, bottle of balls on my ear, saying spoons, don't do it. Double on my shoulder, I don't lack. Hit him with a business, I don't scrap. Even when I'm bar, I'm so easy, right? But there's no car and no match. What are you talking about? Clown, stand down. Never had a thing, never had a pound. You were never bad then, you ain't bad now. Never had them, had a then, no, look back down. Wait, I saw bear kicks, saw bear clothes. Said not that, I can't wear those. I don't like them, they're not my thing. They went silent, they're all weirdos. Like, I'm not about to ask. You see that nigga? He just told you, kill bugs, nigga. You better chill out. Warning your pussy ass. Go to the last one. You gotta make it playoff. Well, I don't, man. I was covering crap like a boot cut. If mad, it's a family thing. Straight family thing. Dumb man, I broke no salary thing. Had a dumb team called Amy telling me to come round hers on a Valerie thing. Hashtag Murky Academy thing. You were like art in the gallery thing. Dumb boy there wanna chat about bars. Wanna chat about. I need to warn you once. I'm gonna warn you again. You put that warning in nice big bold letters so you can see it. My nigga, two company computers and hack shit. Another company, your motherfucking gang system, attack your players and give me the coins. Tell that nigga Nightbox. He bought that life. Man, I'm gonna sick with my tune drops. Little man, that's a who blow, not a who blow. What? Pronounce it right. I go magic, I'm down to die for this. I don't care, bro, I'm down. Man, stress, so I'm bound to lie. My sweat.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gauden, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play.
I don't see no Aaron Donald play. And they dropped a new one.
Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Soldier Field. That's fielded in the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 20.
He got the new Aaron Donald.
Shift together here from the D-line. They'll run it with Jackson. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Just what you want on a first down.
He did. Gotta check him out. See what he's about.
And it's second and two. Now they'll run it on the toss. And some room to roam now. Give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And that's how you get started and open up a game. Really well-blocked play. Picked up a nice chunk of yardage. If you're the offensive line, that's exactly what you've talked about all week long in your meetings. Establish the line of scrimmage and take control. And they gave their running back plenty of room to rumble.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
They'll run it. Here's Peterson. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. Now on fourth and inches, they're going to want to talk this over. We get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. This would have been a 54-yard boot had they tried a field goal, but they will not try a field goal. They're going for it. Now it's Jackson, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It'll be a pickup of just two, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches.
Come in here.
Mariota now to throw on first.
Oh my God, that is fake, man.
Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker.
I should have been through that bitch and gone. Good, man.
Here's Davis now. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Escaping the pressure right. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. 10 yards to go on third. Shotgun now for Rodgers. This is caught by Jackson. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. Rodgers now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. To throw again. Rodgers. Finding room inside the 40. And Davis with it left side. And he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gives him a new set of downs. Fresh set of downs here. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They'll run with Davis. And some room to work. Touchdown, Chicago. A great play there. 36 yards. And the Bears have taken the early lead. And he's got it to make it 7-0 in favor of the Bears. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Now a handoff here to his running back. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd-and-1 situation.
That was another good run, and he's having an excellent day. And right now, I don't think his team could have any more confidence in handing him the football.
And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on 4th down. And he'll give it here to his running back. Through an opening, and there he goes. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. A big play there. 55 yards. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
This will be fielded at the 6. Shifts by him. And he's going to be taken down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Back here with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We've had the kickoff to begin the first quarter. Now it's time for the second quarter kickoff. They've got it 1st and 10 inside their own 20-yard line. There as he winds up flat on his back right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Now Rodgers throwing on 2nd down. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Jackson. And he is out of bounds, getting it across the 30-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. On the carry, it's Davis. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down. Second and 4. They go again with Davis. Room here to run. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And that run was what a lot of people called an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a 2 tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the 2 tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see 2 tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
Rodgers with a keeper. And no signal, but I don't think he got the surge behind center. No, he's going to be kept out of the end zone.
Oh, yeah, good surge defensively. Sometimes you can just tell by the way a quarterback lines his feet up behind center. He's going to try and sneak it in. And they catch him here and stop him for no gain.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. A great effort there. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Bears have taken the lead. And he'll bang that one through. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. And now the Bears going to signal for another timeout. That's their 2nd, so they'll have 1 remaining here in this 2nd quarter. We'll be right back. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the 2-minute warning.
now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So now third and 10. A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And Reed with it over the middle. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. Try the right side here. And some space here. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. 25 yards to pick up there, and also a first down.
All right, I've got to be careful here. All right, he's on the plus side of 30. There may be a little gray in the beard, but that's not slowing down his feet as far as he's concerned.
What are you saying? I'm on the plus side of 30.
Well, if you're on the plus side of 30, you don't know what I'm on the plus side of. All I know is that run right there, let us know there's still some life in those legs.
Absolutely, still got a lot of life left in those legs. Second down, here's Rodgers. A dump off for Davis. A big hit. Knocked down sideways near the 42. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Flushed out right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Now a handoff looking right. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. A great play. And his second touchdown here in the...